Bishop has been the place of inspiration for, I mean, anybody who's ever climbed a bishop or anyone who's ever been there is immediately inspired. When I first went to Bishop, I do remember it, but it's no different than what it is today.
Right hand to this, left hand, right hand.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, it's crazy because, like, you know, we've experienced going around all areas of Bishop and the Buttermilks and, you know, the other areas in Bishop, but it's like the first boulder, you know, the Peabody's. You just stand under this massive overhang and it goes forever, you know? Break your neck looking backwards and you want to climb it. It's nothing more than that. It's the simplest climbing experience, which is looking at a feature in nature, being inspired and climbing it. The way that I have formed my form of expression and discovery and growth is through highballing. This thing that I said I was gonna do was more improbable than I had ever thought. These five highballs were the kind of what Bishop meant to me. Footprints, Ambrosia, Too Big to Flail, This Side of Paradise, and Evolution Direct, all in a day. And the day went perfect, right? The day was not perfect. It was honestly the most heinous sending day I think I had ever committed to in Bishop.
Yeah, those are facts.
I don't want to do Ambrosia twice, you know? Like...
And I was driving out and I couldn't see the mountains. It was just so gloomy, so dark. I was like, oh my God, dude. Like, my first thought was, that means snow. And snow means probably not ideal climbing. Yeah, no chance. No chance we were going for it that day. I mean, mentally I bailed so many times that day. And it was psychologically very difficult to like go from like, yeah, we're stoked, we're going for it, to like, oh, I don't know, like maybe it's not gonna work out, you know, like it's probably not gonna go. And then eventually the snow kind of like started to slow down. So I was like, all right, like maybe we can do this. So I put my shoes on, warmed up on the sunshine slabber a little bit, and I was like, all right, I'm freezing, but this is as warm as I'm gonna need to be for footprints. So kind of just took my time, have this process, and just go down the boulders and like try to really think and just like clear my mind and try to think about it for a little bit for myself. Look up at the climb, try to get inspired, and go for it. I can just do footprints and then bail on the day. And that's not necessarily gonna be a waste for me. It's not gonna be like, wow, like, man, I just risked my life on footprints. Like, it was something that I was very comfortable doing. I'd done it a lot of times at this point. So I was comfortable just like going for footprints and then deciding how the day was gonna go. And that's what I did. So I kind of just went up and I was like, yeah, don't worry about it. Just do footprints and let's get it over with. And then let's think about it.
Okay. Today is the day.
Okay, we're gonna have to suss out Ambrosia. Okay. I mean, it feels amazing, but like,
yeah,
it's so cold.
Ambrosia really is the most free solo feeling out of any of the climbs. Feels like you're embarking on a, you know, a very long boulder, and it feels very exposed. It feels very intense. It's probably the hardest physical moves out of any of the climbing that day. This whole link up project, I knew that doing most of these in a row, I was going to be compromised every boulder that I did. I was going to be heavily impacted. And I knew that, you know, doing the second, third, fourth, and fifth climbs were all going to be dramatically harder than, exponentially harder than I'd ever done these climbs before. That just kind of had its own effect in terms of like my whole commitment to the whole thing. But anyway, yeah, I just kind of went from there, and I don't really remember the bottom of Ambrosia. I just think I pulled on and I was standing on top. To go too big from here. I'm like much more ready to do too big now than any other day. That was intense. There's so many different thoughts that I had that just intruded my confidence, and when I turned around and saw, when I was impressed by the boulder, it wasn't about confidence anymore, it was just about inspiration. I'm having a hard time like even understanding what was happening in my head at that moment, because it's never happened before where I kind of just like didn't realize what was taking my confidence away and like where I needed to get it from. Down, just like stoked, and I was like, all right guys, like good luck, rallied up, Kale and I are out of here. So we hiked out, got to the car, and I was like, all right, we'll just park, we'll just go to this side of Paradise, which is a totally different area. Got to the parking lot and instantly wanted to throw up. I was instantly just feeling the most pressure for anything I'd ever felt in my life. You just dodge a lot of bullets, dude. Like this is not something that's normal. This is a totally improbable thing. This is not likely to happen for anybody. You know, like this is, you're really risking a lot. You're playing a game. Showed up to the boulder, you know, a little bit after everybody else. Chris went down, chalked it up, and he was like very visibly stoked on how it was feeling. And like, that was cool. It gave me so much more confidence. It gave me so much more just like, I don't know, positive energy and belief. Thank you. kind of crazy. Like, the dream had like crystallized for me at that moment, you know, of doing this whole thing, because I kind of knew I was going to do Evolution Direct. I knew it was possible that I didn't, and I knew that it was possible that I could fall and like kind of ruin my skin, but I had like one try left in this index finger. And just, I don't know, man, like I just wanted it to be done. Like all the other boulders, I was waiting for like the moment where I was feeling confident enough to go, you know, and do it. And this one, I just could not wait to get it done. All drove down there, set up the pads. It was getting darker. The sun had just pulled over the mountain, which is exactly when I wanted to do Evolution. And Chris went up, chalked up everything, set the rope up. Said it looked good, it felt good. Bobby went up. This was like a 30 minute long process. And I just was sitting the whole time by my heater, just looking up at the climb, just feeling grateful and inspired and tired and just ready to get it done. Knowing that nothing was certain, I think really just like took a toll on me. And like even to this day, it's hard to talk about without feeling this super intense, like maybe it's just gratefulness for being alive and like getting it done and like having this cool vision. But just relief, man. Like, I mean, we topped it out, just kind of taking it in. It was freezing too. Like just, you know, I did not want to be up there, but I didn't want to be anywhere else.
Let's go! Yeah.
It just felt like a huge chapter of my life that closed, you know.
Fucking go.
Like every moment that is a usual, just like, yeah, it's just what's happening, was so much more real to me. It was so much more just like joyful just to be with everybody and like, I don't know, everything felt more important, you know?
Comfortable with it is to Chris and Jug out.
Dude, Chris.
Did some bouldering, man.
Up this thing.
Yeah. Wait for the journey. That's my favorite.
Bro. Like, look at that.
So, Nate, that side's really good with that side.
Money, you know what I mean?
Oh!